Hey, hello guys, welcome to GiveOps channel where the search for the truth begins. There was a time when Starlink was available only to the US and Canada. Starlink has come to India. The pre-booking is going on now. When Starlink comes to India, they say that the Indian government offices will not use the internet, but it will be called Quantum Internet. We discussed in previous videos about DARPA's advanced weapons projects. What is India's position in this technology? Is India already in the tech race? Are other countries afraid of rapid advancement in technology by India? Elon Musk has already got permission to launch 42,000 satellites for the project Starlink. Elon Musk has entered the market, saying that the devices for Starlink are ready and they are testing it now. This testing mode will be pre-booked in India. The price will be $99. The ultra-fast internet Starlink has started its pre-booking. We still don't know when the technology will be fully available to the Indian public. People who pre-book will receive the Starlink kit. The project Starlink and DARPA's project BlueJack, these projects are for the people who want an ultra-speed internet. Whether it's artificial intelligence or advanced technologies, it needs an ultra-speed internet. Are project Starlink and BlueJack developed only for ultra-speed internet? There is also a mysterious side to these projects. The world knows that AI will be the future. Many countries are trying to implement artificial intelligence into their military. Through R&D, all technologies using AI will be implemented into the military. There is a confusion here. How will they implement all technologies with AI? For example, take radio frequency. There are many frequencies. If you use a radio, you will change the frequency to listen to a radio channel. So using a particular frequency, the radio channels are functioning. Similar to this, the countries of the world use different frequencies for their military. In 2019, America held a contest. The contest name was Blind Signal Classification Challenge. The contestants classified the blind signals and categorized them. The normal people use the frequency to listen to the radio. But in military, for each and every weapons and missile, they might have a different frequency. If a country invades another country, the enemy will try to collect the military frequencies. They will then categorize them as frequency used for tanks, missiles, and satellite communication. The enemy will easily invade and defeat the other country if it has these data. This was the purpose behind the Blind Signal Classification Challenge. In May 2020, they ran a program called HackerSat. This program was conducted virtually. The challenge was to hack a satellite. This challenge was conducted by DARPA and the Pentagon. If a country can hack enemy satellite communications, easily they can beat the enemy. Imagine a single night without a satellite. GPS, streaming services, and mobile phones will not work. There is a huge chance the power grid may fail. So, a country will face many issues if there is no satellite connection. This is the reason India has developed the anti-satellite system through Mission Shakti. India can destroy a satellite using a weapon. The world was stunned to hear India's announcement. The reason is only 3 countries in the world have done a test run in this technology. The 3 countries are China, America, and Russia. India is the 4th country to successfully test this technology. China, America, and Russia are currently developing laser weapons. India is also currently developing the laser weapon technology. The 3 countries are advancing in direct weapon technology. India will start the development of direct energy weapons. India's tech race with other countries has started. What were India's advancements in technology? The answer to this question will be available by March 2021. A tri-service agency was started in India called DSA, Defence Space Agency of the Indian Armed Forces. Just like DARPA and ARIA, India's DSA work will be space warfare and satellite intelligence. DSA will develop technology, weapons, and artificial intelligence to defend India. DSA has been conducting many test runs. In January 2021, DSA calls forth some corporates. DSA tasks them to find out information about the enemy satellites and its activities. After the detection process is completed, they will identify the satellite. After identifying, they will track the satellites. So the process involves detection, identification, and tracking. DSA will also conduct an investigation which will identify the threats to India. To successfully accomplish their tasks, DSA through COP, Common Operating Picture, will collect surveillance data and transform the data into a simple operation picture for the Indian Army. Many countries could have launched satellites into space. DSA through COP will identify the radio frequencies and direct energy weapons data. The COP with the data available will send a clear picture to the Indian Armed Forces. This process is difficult. In order to complete this full operation, India needs many advanced technologies. India has started to select the companies which will develop these technologies. After the selection process is done, India will know how to process the signals in space. We will use this technology to protect and go on the offense against the enemy if needed. Within 2 years, the Indian people will be talking about this technology. Please search for India's DSA projects. Similar to DARPA, DRDO is important to India. Many countries are taking steps to build a space army. If India has to compete with the leading countries in the technology, DSA's projects are very important to India. Comments about this video are most welcome. Please do subscribe and share for more content to WikiVox, the voice of Tamil Pokisham. Please give a like to this video and please hit the notification icon. Nandri, Vanakkam.